Hello everyone. This is a recording to show off the impressive capabilities of this little tape recorder thing over here. It's actually just a stereo recorder, though it can be set up that way. As you see, I've got it set to 44.1, 8 channel. And the way you do that is you go up here to tape recorder options and you select the number of channels over here. And see, I've got it catching 8 channels in at 16 bits, 44.1, and VWF format, which is like an advanced wave format. It captures time code and stuff like that. It's the standard, started in Europe, that's now pretty much the standard for video and film everywhere. And you'll notice that for my post fader output, I've selected virtual bus B2. That is this bus right here. I'm going to be recording from that bus. So that's why I've got everything sent to the B2 bus as well as to the B1 bus, which is going to this recording that you're hearing. So the B1 bus is just a stereo recording, but this B2 is a special composite recording. Now what composite means is that it's grabbing, well actually let me just show you something here. I'll go ahead and play some sound. So you've got FUBAR playing in one. And this is actually media player, and let's bring up FUBAR and play it, and VLC. I've also got some content. There we have it. And so you see I have three media players playing on top of the microphone. I guess this is my VLC. This is the ambience from one, and this is the ambience from the other. I've got beach sounds, and I've got some other sounds going on, forest sounds. And so you'll see how active all of this is over here on the right, where it's got several channels all going at once. Now what I've done is I've sent all of these channels some content from the menu. You have to go to System Settings and Options, and here's where I've set this up. I've got my microphone. I only need the one channel. So I've got input left. And these go input 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay? So I have input left as the input here. Okay? I have input 2 left and right, because that's getting a stereo ambience. Oh, a stereo music in this case. And I hope I'm not overwhelming, by the way. I'm still perfectly capable. You can hear me fine. I got 3, which is this one, which is an ambience, which I want left and right, stereo. And I've got number 4 is just sound effect, like here we are, spacecraft passing. There you go. So 4, since it's, I can bring it in as mono because it'll work just fine mono. And then left, I've got another ambience from the media player coming in through the Voicemeeter aux input. Now I have 3 videos that show how to set each one of these media players to direct its output to different outputs. I'm using the cable output, the VB Audio Virtual Cable. It's a free one. And then if you make a donation, I would recommend making a donation if you're using these. Then you get access to the cable A and cable B as well, so that you can use those as further cables to output stuff to. And of course, you've got the Voicemeeter auxiliary, which is what I've got the other media player going to. So watch those videos if you want to see how to set those settings. Now let's go ahead and get this recording started. And because I have all this already set up now. So you click the record button. Okay, now I am recording into the cassette 8 channels simultaneously. This composite is set here. It's set to composite, which means it's pulling pre-fader before the fader. So it won't pick up any fades that I make where I reduce the amount of sound, okay? It's taking everything in at full volume. Okay, so when I do that, it's getting it as the full volume. If I pull down any faders, it's not going to care in the recording about the pull down faders. It's pulling everything in pre-fader. Oh, actually, no, wait. This is pulling in post-fader. Pay no attention to what I'm saying. This is post-fader. So it actually is recording any changes I make to the faders. Okay, well that's good to know. Now, so as this recording is going, it's really great because I can have this mix down that I'm sending it, like just like I'm sending to this recording. I can have my mix down going out to a live show where everybody's hearing my effects as I'm doing them live and including them. And by the way, all of these effects come from the audio library at YouTube. You simply click on your Creator Studio button. This is how it's currently done. And click on the Create button over here and click on Audio Library, and these will show up with music and sound effects. So that's how this all happens. And you get several sound effects that you can play live. And I'm using this, actually playing right from the browser, so that's why it's playing into my default input right here. If I've got everything else, my media players are all going to special. Okay, enough of that. Well, my media player is going into special outputs. Okay. So that's kind of really cool, isn't it? And, that I've got four, basically, 1, 2, 3, 4 outputs plus a mic all being mixed together in a live format going out as a stereo mix. Plus, each individual track is recording into this recorder so I can do some post-processing later on. Okay, so let's go ahead and turn off this recorder and I'll show you how you actually get this into a digital audio workstation to be able to work with it. So we'll stop that. Oh, and that's pause, sorry. There we go. Hitting the record button once puts it in a pause mode. So I hit stop. And let's go ahead and stop these media players. There we go. There we go. Okay. And still got this playing. All right. Let's bring up Harrison Mixbus as an example. And go up to session, import. Now any DAW is going to have an import thing. And you see I have this going by when it's modified. This is most recently modified here at the top. So I'm selecting that. And I'm using it as adding files as new tracks. And at the playhead or at session start, either way, since I have my playhead. Oh, actually, I better set it at session start. Here we go. And it'll default to saying one track per file, but we only have, we have an 8-track, an 8-channel single file. So what you want to select is one track per channel, okay? And you can, by the way, usually audition. Okay, now I'm recording. So there you have the preview. All right, so one track per channel. Hit apply. It'll process the WAV file and bring it in. And it's 8 tracks, and bingo. Now you see it. 8 tracks of audio. So let me go ahead and rewind this thing. And okay, now I'm recording. And this is all coming in.
Channels simultaneously. This composite is set here. It's set to composite.
So as you can see, I probably would want to do some before the fader. Some mixing with this right away. Turn down the sound.
Okay.
So I'm hoping that you're not hearing it.
Taking everything in at full
volume. It's completely loud as I'm hearing it right there.
It's getting it as
full volume. You get it. It brought in 8 tracks. Now I can work on a post-production thing. These are 44:1 16-bit, the way I set it. And so that's the basic gist of what I wanted to show you in this recording, was how I can do a live show. I can output my tracks individually into this little tape recorder thing. I don't even have to have the DAW running, recording. I can record it right into Voicemeeter, into the cassette, as 8 tracks, 8 channels. I should say 8 channels. And then bring the 8 channels in to my digital audio workstation and work with them. Okay, so that's pretty much all I wanted to show you in this video. And I hope that gets you kind of excited about some of the capabilities. I'll have the download links for the media players and for Voicemeeter and for the virtual cables, or the Bane virtual cable, in the description for the video. So have fun with this. I know you're going to have fun with this. Take care.